Srila Gurudev, Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, has chosen Navadvip Dham, which is non-different from Vrindavan Dham, as a place for his eternal Samadhi Kunja.
Kavi Karnapur has described glory of Srila Rupa Goswami. In fact, he felt that words are not enough. Priya Swarupe, most exalted amongst all of those who got Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy. Daita Swarupe, the dearest one. Nijan Rupe, that Swarup which Mahaprabhu himself would like to have. He wanted to be like him. And his desire has manifested in Srila Rupa Goswami. Praburaya Rupe, Sri Rupa Goswami is none different from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is that person who really desires to realize who Mahaprabhu is and what he has in his heart. One can see that in the literature of Rupa Goswami. Only by his mercy one can realize who Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is. Tatana Rupe, that Swarup which Mahaprabhu was always eager to see again and again. Svavilasa Rupe, Sri Rupa Goswami is that person who can do absolutely everything understand all the bhavas Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has manifested. Only he could understand their depth. When someone comes to your home, to some you would like to allow enter, but it doesn't mean that they can freely roam inside and do whatever they want. Others you invite to feel comfortable, but there are those to whom you allow to do everything, and that makes you happy. Exactly like that, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu opened the doors of his own heart to Rupa Goswami and let him do as he liked. Mahaprabhu told, "Whatever I have, treat it as your own. If you like, distribute to others everything what I have, without any doubts." Prema Swarupe, the embodiment of the highest love and affection. Mahaprabhu stayed with Sanatana Goswami in Kashi for some time, giving him lucid instructions on Jiva Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva, Maya Tattva and Sambandha Tattva. He explained that the performance of devotional service bhakti is Abhidei Tattva and that pure love of God Krishna Prema is Prayojana Tattva. Empowering him thus, Mahaprabhu ordered him to go to Vrindavan and manifest the lost holy places there, compose devotional literature and establish the worship of the ancient deities of Vrindavan. Thus empowered, Sri Sanatana Goswami fulfilled Srimad Mahaprabhu's inner desire by manifesting lost holy places of Vrindavan, establishing the service of Srimad and Mohan, and compiling Hari Bhakti Vilas, Brihad Bhagavatamritam, and a commentary on Srimad Bhagavatam's 10th canto. Vairagi Yug Bhakti Rasam Prayatnaya Apayanvana Bhipsamandham Kripam Budhirya Paraduka Dukhi Sanatanastam Prabhumashrayam. Raghunadas Goswami has glorified Sanatana Goswami as follows in his Vilapakusumanjali, verse 6. I was unwilling to drink the nectar of devotional service, possessed of renunciation, but Sanatana Goswami, out of his causeless mercy, made me to drink it, even though I was unable to do so. Therefore, he is an ocean of mercy. He is very much compassionate to fallen souls like me, and thus it's my duty to offer my respectful obeisances unto his lotus feet and take shelter of him. The transcendental position of Sanatana Goswami is glorified in the Gaur Kanadesha Dipika of Shikavi Karnapura. Sarupa Manjari Presiha Purasi Trati Manjari Sachyate Nama Bhedana Lavanga Manjari Budhai. Rupa Manjari's closest friend, who was known by the names Rati Manjari and Lavanga Manjari, appeared in the pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Sri Sanatana Goswami, who was considered to be a personal extension of the body of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. First, we should know the identity of Srila Raghunadas Goswami. Srila Gopal Guru Goswami has stated in his Padhati that in his Siddha Swarup, his spiritual form in Golok Vrindavan, Srila Raghunadas Goswami is Sri Rati Manjari, and her nickname is Sri Tulsi Manjari. All the Sakis, all the Gopis address her as Tulsi Manjari, although they also sometimes address her as Rati Manjari. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left this world, Srila Raghunadas Goswami felt shelterless. He had previously been eating rice, dal and sound, but after Srimad Mahaprabhu left, he took only fruits and milk. Within 3 or 4 months, Sri Swarup Damodara also left and joined Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in Aprakat Lila, his eternal pastimes in the spiritual world. And at that time, Raghunadas also gave up taking even fruits and milk. He soon proceeded to Vrindavan and planned to give up his life by jumping from Govardhana Hill. Previously, while he had been living in Jagannath Puri, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave him 2 deities, a Govardhana Shila and a Gunjamala, necklace of Gunja beads, representing Srimati Radhika, which Sankarananda Saraswati had given the Lord upon returning from Vrindavan. Srimad Mahaprabhu personally used to perform worship of this Shila by offering the water of his tears and the flowers as moods of his heart. Sometimes he kept it on his heart, sometimes on his head, sometimes on his eyelids, and sometimes he couldn't find any satisfying place. After 3 months, Sriman Mahaprabhu gave the shield to Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, who considered, by doing this, Mahaprabhu has given me to Govardhan. I should serve Govardhan. And by giving me this Gunjamala, he has offered me to the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. He came with this to duties to Vrindavan, and there he met Srila Rupa Goswami and Srila Sanatana Goswami. He told them about his idea of going to Govardhan, but he did not disclose his plan to give up his life by jumping from Govardhan. They could understand his intention. However, and Srila Sanatana Goswami instructed him, "Don't do so. You are my brother, and Srila Rupa Goswami is also." Srila Sanatana Goswami now told Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, "So, you can die, but you cannot receive Krishna prema by such an act. Rather than die, it's better to perform bhajan at Radhakund, Govardhan, Vrindavan and other places of Srimati Radharani and Krishna's pastimes." Raghunath Das Goswami lived on the banks of Radhakunda without any fixed residence, staying under a different tree every night. Sometimes he would stay on the banks of Mansi Ganga. At that time, these areas were jungles filled with ferocious animals. One day, Sanatana Goswami came to the banks of Mansi Ganga to meet Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Before accepting his noon meal at Gopal Bhatta's bhajan kutir, he went to take bath at the Pavan Ghat of Mansi Ganga. From there, he saw two tigers coming to the kund, and after drinking some water, they left. Just near that spot, Raghunath Das Goswami was sitting under a tree, absorbed in his bhajan. Sanatana Goswami was startled to see this, but even more so when he saw Sri Krishna standing at some distance, observing everything. He then requested Raghunath to do his bhajan within a hut. On another occasion, Raghunath Das, who still hadn't bothered to have a kutir constructed, was sitting in the noonday sun, absorbed in his bhajan. Srimati Radharani happened to pass that way at that time, and seeing that the sun was beating down on Raghunath's head, she stood behind him and held the end of her sari to shield him from the sunny rays. Then one of the Goswami came along and saw this heart-rending scene, while profuse perspiration continued to flow from Srimati Radharani's transcendental body. This time, when he was again requested to do his bhajan in a kutir, Raghunath Das Goswami immediately agreed to comply. When Gopal arrived in Vrindavan, Rupa and Sanatan wrote to Mahaprabhu to tell him. The Lord was overjoyed and immediately wrote back, telling them to affectionately take care of him as though he were their own younger brother. Srila Sanatana Goswami compiled the Hari Bhakti Vilas and published it in Srila Gopal Bhatta Goswami's name. Rupa Goswami considered Gopal to be as dear to him as his own life and engaged him in the deity worship of Radharaman. It is said that Mahaprabhu had such affection for Gopal Bhatta that he sent him his own belt and kaupina as well as the wooden seat which he had used. These items are still worshipped in the Radharaman temple by the current servants. When Srila Gopal Bhatta Goswami was visiting the pilgrimage centers of northern India, he found Ashalagram Srila on the banks of the Gandaki river. He took the worshipable stone and carried it with him wherever he went, treating it as Rajendranandan Krishna himself. One day, he thought that he would like to worship the Lord in a deity form so that he could expand his service. On the very next day, he found that Shalagram Srila had transferred itself into Radharaman to fulfill the wish of his devotee. The deity stands with the symbol of Radharani, a silver crown is placed on his left side. The annual festival commemorating Radharaman's appearance when he is bathed publicly takes place on the full moon of day of Vaishak. The Radharaman temple is considered one of the most important in Vrindavan. Srila Gopal Bhatta Goswami's Samadhi temple is behind the current Radharaman temple. By reading Srinivasacharya's hymn to the six Goswamis, Sat Goswami Ashtaka, we can understand something of their glories. Manchakam pasutaram
Sharada Vanala Lira Loka Pranaya Parina Ghana Ghana Tyam.
The pastimes of Lokanath Das Goswami have not been told in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita or in any other book. Lokanath Das Goswami was such a topmost elevated Vaishnava that he warned Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Srila Rupa Goswami, Srila Sanatana Goswami and other writers, "If you want my mercy, then don't glorify me or write my name in your books." When they assured him of this, only then did he give his blessings and tell him, "Your books will be successfully completed. Krishna's mercy will be on you." It's for this reason that these great Vaishnava authors have not mentioned his name. They obeyed him. They followed his order. Srila Narottam Thakur was a prince. He was the son of a very famous king in that area. From childhood, he had impressions of pure devotion and wanted to cultivate them. After the generation of the six Goswamis and Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, Narottam Thakur, Shyamananda Prabhu and Srinivas Acharya became the leaders of the Vaishnavas in Bengal. They took all the books of the six Goswamis and other authentic Vaishnava literatures and preached all over Bengal. Narottam Das Thakur was not an ordinary devotee. He was an associate of Srimati Radhika herself. Narottam Das Thakur manifested six deities there, namely Radha Govinda, Radha Gopinath, Radha Madan Mohan, Radha Vamshidhari, Radha Giridhari and Radha Valavikanta. He also organized a great festival that became famous in the Gaudiya Vaishnava history. Srimati Janavi Devi herself, who is an Angamanjari in Krishna Lila, the wife of Nityananda Prabhu, was elected as a president. All accepted her like their preceptor, including Srila Jiva Goswami and Raghunath Das Goswami.
The whole world is indebted to Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. He mercifully left India and went to all the Western and Eastern countries. In a very short time, in just a few years, he preached the mission of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, of Srila Rupa Goswami, and of his Gurudev, Nityananda Pravishta on Vishnupad, Shishimad Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. He wrote and translated many books, wonderful books. He translated authentic scriptures into English, like the Bhagavad Gita, the Srimad Bhagavatam, and Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. He also wrote books himself, such as Krishna Book and the teachings of Lord Chaitanya. He then printed hundreds and thousands of copies of these in all the important languages of the world and had his dedicated disciples and followers distribute them everywhere. He established ISKCON, the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, and he opened preaching centers all over the world. After he established all this, his spiritual master called him back to the spiritual world, and thus he returned to Goloka Vrindavan. Just prior to his departure, Srila Swami Maharaj had requested Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj that he would perform the ceremony of placing him in Samadhi after his disappearance. He said, "I don't want to take Samadhi from anyone else's hand. I think you are the proper person. After placing me in Samadhi, please arrange to celebrate Naviraha Mahotsav, or festival of separation. You should invite all the Vaishnavas and the respected Brajavasis, and you should give some donation to the seven main temples in Vrindavan and to all the Gaudiya Maths." Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj was not an ordinary devotee. If he was, he would not have been able to preach all around the world the way he did in such a short space of time. Remembering him, Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj said, "I consider him my Siksha Guru, and he always lives in the temple of my heart. I had a very intimate friendship with him. I think that he is always present here with us, and I pray to him that he will bestow mercy upon us, so that we will all enter into Raganuga Bhakti and Prema Bhakti in this very lifetime."
Sharada Vanala Lila Loka
Sri Prabhudananda Saraswati was the guru and parental uncle of Sri Gopal Bhatta Goswami. He was a transcendental poet, well versed in all the shastras. Radharasa Sudanidhi, Sri Navadvipa Shataka, and Sri Vrindavan Shataka are some of the works of this Mahapurush. In his famous Gaura Ganadesh Deepika, Sri Kavi Karnapur has mentioned that Prabhudananda Saraswati is the very talented Tunga Vidya Sakhi, one of the Asta Sakhis in Krishna Lila. After Srila Haridas Thakur departed from this world, Mahaprabhu took his transcendental body, and together with all the bhaktas and devotees, he carried him to the ocean. There, they performed the Abhishek of Haridas Thakur. They applied tilak to his body, gave him new dog open, and then offered him Jagannath Mahaprasad and Jagannath Pasta. After all this, Sriman Mahaprabhu gave Samadhi to Haridas Thakur with his own hands. Mahaprabhu then explained that anyone who was present at the Samadhi giving ceremony, who helped to establish it, even if by offering just one handful of sand, anyone who saw the ceremony, did Nam Sankirtan there, or just offered respect to it, they will all attain Prema Bhakti, Krishna Bhakti, and Braja Bhakti.
The construction of the Samadhi Mandir of our beloved Srila Gurudev started in the year 2014, and by the mercy of Srila Gurudev is continuing to manifest beautifully. We can witness all the changes that have happened so far in this period. When ordinary people leave this world, their dead body is burned or thrown in water. Some cultures have other methods to dispose of their bodies, and they might even keep a memorial place for that person. However, such a place is not helpful. It will not give Krishna Bhakti or help purify the soul. Why is that? Because ordinary people do not identify with their soul. They only believe in and have attachment for their body. In contrast, both the body and soul of a Mahabhagavat Vaishnava are transcendental. Before, Srila Gurudev came as just one deity, but when that one disappeared, he manifested himself as many deities. If anyone faithfully serves his deity, then Srila Gurudev will be present there. This is called a Samadhi Center or Samadhi Kunja. Anyone who serves in this way will realize all these things. His prema will be equal or sama, and he will think, I am with Gurudev and Gurudev is with me. Srila Gurudev Samadhi Center is very powerful. Anyone who serves and remembers his Samadhi, who goes there daily to pray, will receive all Satchidananda Tattva, or all spiritual knowledge, and he will establish a loving relationship with God. Krishna has said that Sri Guru and all the Mahabhagavat Vaishnavas are non-different from him. Worshipping and following those who are dear to Krishna is more beneficial than worshipping and following Krishna directly. So this applies to Srila Gurudev and our Guru Varga. If anyone truly takes shelter of them at their Samadhi center by offering obeisance, hearing their glories, doing Nam Kirtan, performing a little bit of service, or trying to follow in the footsteps of senior devotees, even if such a person has no knowledge at all, Sri Guru and the Vaishnavas will give him the qualification or adhikar to enter into the eternal Golok Vrindavan. The Samadhi Center is like a branch office of the Samadhi Kunja in Goloka Vrindavan. All the conditioned living entities are physically arrested by the five material elements, and it is not possible for them to break their relationship with these elements and cross over Maya. However, when they come to the Samadhi and start praying, this physical attachment can very easily be cut. They can then enter in their subtle body and take shelter of the Samadhi Kunja. Under guidance of the Vaishnavas, they will pray and follow all the limbs of bhakti. They will not engage in idle gossip and they will be very serious. When our soul attains Swarup Siddhi, we will go to the eternal world together with Sri Guru Pada Padma to perform service there. We will still have a physical structure, a material body and mind, but we will no longer have any relationship with it. This is called Sahaja Samadhi, or natural, real Samadhi. To attain this, training at the Samadhi center of a bona fide divine master is necessary. It is not possible to receive this training anywhere else. Therefore, when our Guru Varga returns to the spiritual world, They kindly leave behind the spiritual structure, their Samadhi temple. From there, they are helping, teaching, training, and making the conditioned souls qualified. When you come to the Samadhi Kunja, you will understand that it is non-different from Vrindavan Dham. It is Chintamani Sarup made of wish-fulfilling jewels. Yoga Pit is also present there. And it is from this place that Ladini Shakti, the Lord's pleasure-giving potency, spreads her power in all directions. Srila Gurudev says that all sadhaks should come to the Samadhi every day and pray for eternal service. They should pray to Gurudev, "When will I be able to enter into this eternal Navadvip Dham and see how all the inhabitants of the Dham are serving Mahaprabhu?" Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains that when our Guru Varga descends from the spiritual world into this world, they enter into a body. This body is like a temple or a kunjakatir in which they perform their service. But when their manifest pastimes come to an end, then, by the order of Swarup Shakti, they move to another kunja and serve from there. The Guru Varga like to share their wealth of bhakti with the conditioned jivas. To continuously help these jivas, they open their own center or branch office, their Samadhi Kunja. All their activities have one purpose, to give Braj Bhakti to the conditioned souls. If anyone comes to their Samadhi Kunja, following everything they previously learned from their Guru and aspiring to fulfill their Guru's desire, then the Guru Varga will personally pray for them and help them achieve their goal. In our Gaudiya line, Samadhi means Samadhi, or deep absorption. One who reaches this level of meditation is always engaged in Krishna Seva in Goloka Vrindavan, under the guidance of Srimati Radharani in the mantras. One will be engaged there in service and will never be restless. This kind of Samadhi is real, and it is called Antardasha. On the ground floor of Srila Gurudev's Samadhi, Srila Gurudev is present with the Guru Varga and all his eternal associates. If we go to him by Guru Mantra and Guru Gayatri, we will be able to see how Srila Gurudev is serving the Guru Parampara and how he is also arranging for us to be engaged in his service. He gives Seva Adhikar, or the qualification to serve the Guru Varga. Guru Mantra and Guru Gayatri can give everything to the sadhak, including spiritual relationship, affection, and a loving service tendency. On the first floor of the Samadhi, Mahaprabhu is present. May that Lord, who is known as the son of Srimati Sachi Devi, be transcendentally situated in the innermost chambers of your heart. Resplendent with the radiance of molten gold, he has appeared in the age of Kali by his causeless mercy to bestow what has not been given in a very long time. Mandri Bhav, the service of Srimati Radhika as her confidential maidservant. Mahaprabhu is not distributing power for the body or mind. He is distributing power for the soul. He came to the world for this purpose. On the first floor of the Samadhi, Srila Gurudev takes us to Mahaprabhu, who gives soul potency. We have taken millions of physical births, but our soul, our very essence, has not yet taken birth. How can our soul take birth? Srila Gurudev gives Gaura Mantra and Gaura Gayatri and instructs us to chant these mantras. By chanting Gaura Mantra, we can enter into Samadhi Yoga. Bhu Shakti Vishnu Priya, Shri Shakti Lakshmi Priya, Leela Shakti Gadadhar Pandit, and all others give Seva Adhikar for Mahaprabhu's service. By chanting Gaura Gayatri, Mahaprabhu's Panchatattva and all the Pancharasas will come and teach us how to serve. If anyone comes to Srila Gurudev's Samadhi Kunja by mantra, with respect, love, and faith, then Srila Gurudev will take that person to Sri Gaura Hari. By chanting Gaura mantra and Gaura Gayatri, Gaura Hari bestows consciousness and inspires the soul to take birth. The soul will then attain its own swarup and body, and will receive instructions and training for its eternal service. This center for spiritual guidance is called Brajpatan, Chaitanya Mat, Guru Pit, or Samadhi Kunja. The soul will no longer have any connection with this material body and mind, or with this mundane world of Maya Devi, and he will cease to move inside the cycle of birth and death. The second floor of the Samadhi is Giri Nukunja, and it is the training center of the Palyadasis. On the bank of this eternal Govardhan, Srila Gurudev teaches us how to pray. He prays by singing the songs of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He remembers other songs, such as Ramani Shiromani, Radhika Charana Padma, Radhika Charana Renu, and Dekite Dekite. When the sadhak comes to the Samadhi Kunja, he will also pray by singing and meditating upon these songs. He will remember how Srila Gurudev is dressing Srimati Radharani and how he is serving her. The sadhak will learn how to sing, cook, and clean nicely. And by the order of Srimati Radharani, Srila Gurudev will come there to teach him and give him training. The Samadhi Kunja is Srila Gurudev's permanent training center. He is always checking, how many people are coming to me? However, if anyone prays for something other than to develop bhakti, Srila Gurudev will not answer their prayers. He will only help those who have the desire to serve Srimati Radharani. Srila Gurudev gives us Gopal Mantra and Krishna Gayatri. By the training of Sri Gaura Hari and with the help of Sri Nityananda Prabhu, Sri Advaita Prabhu, the Dvadasha Gopal, Chosrati Mahanta, Ashta Kaviraj, and Shad Goswami, it becomes possible to enter into the eternal Vrindavan, where we will attain Vastu Siddhi. The Samadhi is the door to this eternal Goloka Vrindavan. We will realize Gopal Swarup, Gopi Swarup, and Gokul Swarup. By Krishna Gayatri, Srila Gurudev takes us to eternal Goloka Vrindavan and grants us a residential permit. He also gives us spiritual engagement and our permanent service. The second floor of the Samadhi Kunja is Seva Kunja, as well as Nidhuvan, Bandiravan, Ramshivat, Yavat, and Kokilavan. Srila Gurudev is very busy with his eternal service. If anyone, after attaining Swarup Siddhi, comes to this place, Srila Gurudev will train that person in seva and how to please Srimati Radharani and the Braj Gopis. Under the guidance of Srimati Radharani, the sadhak will pray, Kabe Krishna, Kabe Krishna, Kabe Krishna Dhana Bhava. And again he will pray, when, oh when will he accept me? When will he accept my service? Das Goswami, Rupa Goswami, and their entire Guru Varga pray on the bank of Govardhan near Radhakuni. Srila Gurudev teaches us the prayers, Sri Rupa Manjari Pada, Tavaye Vasmi, Tavaye Vasmi, Yat Kinkari Shubhahusha Kalukakuvani, and Ha Devi Kakubaraga Gadaya Devacha. This eternal practice of praying is called Samadhi Kunja. It is Siddha Pranali under the guidance of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Srila Gurudev and our Guru Varga are continuously teaching and helping us. So this Samadhi Kunja is also Seva Kunja, a training center. If anyone goes to the Samadhi with faith and respect, they will realize that Srila Gurudev is present there helping one and all. Srila Gurudev teaches us to go to the Samadhi of Srila Raghunath Das Goswami and all the Sad Goswamis, to Srila Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, and to Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, so that we can realize our soul's identity. To help the jivas of this world, these personalities have come from the transcendental world with their soul temple. The Guru Varga is always present in Samadhi, and so their body is like their Samadhi Kunja. They are forever serving Sri Sri Radha Govinda in their eternal Sarup. We may not understand their direct instructions, but by chanting our mantras and by touching, respecting, and praying to their samadhis, in time we will definitely come to understand. Everything at a samadhi is beneficial for the jivas. Srila Gurudev is present in this Giri Nikunja. Anyone who comes to this Kunja Kutir is very lucky. This samadhi center is Chintamani Moy Radha Kunja Tata Tahe Kunja Shata Shata. If anyone desires Prema Bhakti, they will definitely come to this Samadhi Kunja. The Samadhi Center also serves as Udipan, or a stimulus, for remembering Srila Gurudev's eternal pastimes and seva. Here, all Srila Gurudev's spiritual moods, like his Alambana, Vibhav, Anubhav, Satvika Bhav, and Vyabhichari Bhav, mix together and turn into rasa. And from here, Srila Gurudev engages everyone in seva in the spiritual world. If anyone, desiring to realize his own eternal mood and service, comes to the samadhi and prays to Srila Gurudev for this, then Srila Gurudev will surely answer their prayers. A bona fide sevak is always present with his Gurudev. He is serving his Guru in the eternal world, and in this world, he discloses and manifests his Guru's eternal seva and swarup. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains in Jaiva Dharma that ordinary people use clay, wood, straw, or husk to make a deity, and then they worship this deity. But a Mahabhagavat is eternally serving his Vilap, his beloved God, in samadhi, or trance. In Bhayadasha, external consciousness, he is serving, and he continues to serve in Antardasha, internal consciousness, or samadhi. When Antardasha comes, he suffers in separation. When the separation becomes so painful that he cannot tolerate it anymore, he manifests the eternal swarup of his beloved Lord. This swarup is not temporary, it is eternal. A sadhak who is doing sadhan to attain perfection has no tension whatsoever. He will go to Srila Gurudev's eternal samadhi kunja, and there he will be connected with the eternal world and his eternal guru seva. At the time of sadhan, the sadhak should be connected with the eternal world. Detached from everything, he will be together with his bona fide divine master in samadhi yoga. Thus, he will be able to realize the entire transcendental reality. The only purpose of a samadhi center is to give training. At the samadhi, the sadhak is within the safety and protection of our Mahabhagavat Guru Varga, and it is for this eternal training that the samadhi center manifests. This samadhi kunja is not just a memorial place. It is an eternal center of Braj Bhumi in this world, and Braj Bhakti will descend very easily into the heart of a sadhak who comes there and sings, remembers, and meditates on Braj Kirtan, or the songs of the Brajvasis. Now, to their immense good fortune, people from all around the world are coming to Srila Gurudev's Samadhi. If the Samadhi temple bestows its mercy, then their eyes will open and they will understand God's deities and temple. Only bona fide divine personalities can access the spiritual world, but this Samadhi Kunja is to help everyone. It is a merciful and blissful place of training. One who collects blessings from this Samadhi Kunja can truly enter into Samadhi and gain entrance into the spiritual world, where the inhabitants are waiting for us, asking, "Who is coming? Who wants to serve God?" When someone comes for spiritual guidance, Srila Gurudev will give entrance and admission. When a member of the Guru Varga departs, everybody all over the world, and even God himself, glorifies that personality. They construct a glorious temple for him, which serves as a permanent and sweet place of shelter for both the sadhaks and the siddhas. Such a place will continuously shower nectar on everyone, and God himself will also love that place. We are all very lucky when a Samadhi Kunja of a Mahabhagavat manifests before us.
My name is Radhika Dasi, and right now I'm standing on the third floor of Srila Gurudev's Samadhi, Mandir. And I was actually remembering this one time when I was with Gurudev in an airport darshan in San Francisco. And I was expressing to Gurudev that I was having some difficulty in my chanting Harinam. And Gurudev told me many, many stories and many, many things. And finally, at the end, when he was done talking to me, he closed his eyes and he said, "When you realize what I am giving you, then you will be able to do like me." And he closed his eyes and he started to chant Harinam in a very, very deep and beautiful way. And for those of you that have seen, like when Gurudev closes his eyes, it's like he's like, whoop, somewhere else. And then when he opens his eyes again, he's like back to earth, you know, except never exactly back to earth. So in this way, Gurudev right now, he's here and he's doing his Samadhi bhajan. And this entire Samadhi is the highest glorification of his Harikata and his moods and a commemoration of those topmost things which he came to give us. And Goloka Vrindavan itself, because Gurudev is here and all of his transcendental associates are here. This is the highest glorification of the Guru Parampara, of Mahaprabhu Leela, and of Radharani and Krishna's pastimes, which Gurudev came door to door to give to us. So I'm really fortunate to be here with all my god brothers and god sisters, and the Samadhi constructions went so wonderfully. And I'm so happy to finally be able to share with you what the plan is for the third floor, because the third floor is going to be all Radha Krishna Leela, and for the plan of the Samadhi, because we had a very special visitor, Shamrani Devi herself, who came, and for months and months I was meditating like how to arrange, you know, these different murtis in the rooms, like where they'll fit and where is the proper place, because, you know, I have no brain, I don't know anything. So then Shamrani came, and in like 5 minutes she like helped me come up with some kind of a, you know, where the murti should go and the order of the pastimes. So on the very right hand side over here, this is the third floor. This is gonna be where Jayashree goes. This is the order of how they appear in Gita Govinda. Over here, it's going to be Radharani alone. All these cows are going to be out, and they're going to be over there. Over there, behind the big dome, that's where Gurudev is going to be sitting down there. And behind Gurudev, there's going to be a big Giriraj Govinda. And then over here, this is Manani Radha, so Krishna's actually behind Radhika, breaking Radharani's man. Here you see an empty booth, and that's because the murtis haven't been made yet. This is going to be a depiction of Param Gurudev's Astakam, about Radhavinod Bihari. So Krishna is going to be meditating and sitting under the Imli Tala tree, chanting Radharani's names. This is going to be another pastime, which is currently unrevealed, but one idea was to do one of the Gita Govinda pastimes of Radha and Krishna walking through the forest. This is going to be Gopi Geet, except nothing is in order right now, but Gopi Geet will be here. And this is hopefully going to be blocked out so that it's, you know, one separate prakosh. And Seva Kunja, hopefully we can move them lower down. And Gurudev will be over there. He's sitting there and he is looking at his heart and soul, his Swamini Shivati Radhika, and all of Rupa Manjari, Rati Manjari, and his Samadhi Smaran. And then over here, this is going to be Srila Kusmanjali. Shamrani Didi is working on the most beautiful, exquisite new painting with all the Astasakis and Radha Krishna and some very special mandiris. And those are all going to be here in her, for her new Vilak Kusmanjali painting. Here you see another empty booth, and that's because this also doesn't have Murtis made yet. But we're thinking to do Brahmara Geet for here. That was one of the paintings that Gurudev, there was a few paintings, actually it was really interesting when we put all the Murtis in the Samadhi, there was about three or four spaces that weren't filled on the third floor. And Shamrani Didi said that there was a few paintings that Gurudev specifically requested her to do, which hadn't been done yet. So if they could be made into Murtis, it's like Gurudev's perfect arrangement. So Brahmara Geet and Venu Geet over here. And then here, this is going to be another lila from Vilap Kusmanjali, where Krishna has prepared this beautiful kunja, and Srimati Radhika comes, and then she's trying to leave, and Krishna's blocking the kunja so that Radharani can't leave. And actually, Gurudev himself posed for the line drawing. He posed as Krishna, putting his arms out. So that also hasn't, that pastime also hasn't been made yet. Here, this is a sketch that I think is being worked on by Manjari Didi, that Gurudev asked her to do a painting of Rupa Manjari, also a verse from Lakhas Manjari, of Rupa Manjari massaging the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. Sri Rupa Manjari Kadana is verse from Lakhas Manjari, which we still need Murtis for. And here we have Prem Samput. They're going to be lifted. Actually, everything, like all of this background is going to be covered with background painting, you know, creepers, leaves, grass, birds, flowers, like it's not going to be white tiles. All the bars will be painted with beautiful, like, creeper decorations, and it's going to be, like, really beautiful. And over there in that booth, this is going to be Yashoda Krishna. They're not in there right now, but those Murtis are completed, but they're not in there. But that's going to be Yashoda Krishna. And then if you come over to this side, over here, standing just behind Gurudev. Gurudev is sitting in his favorite place in the whole entire world, which is Govardhan. Govardhan here, Govardhan will be here, and all the cows and cowherd boys will be here by Govardhan. Gurudev went all over the world and established Anukut festivals everywhere, so you can come here and offer 56 preparations every day to Gurudev. And down there on the second floor, on the far, the far right, over here. That's going to be Mahaprabhu's Janmalila, the Nimshi, and then Mahaprabhu delivering Jagar Mandai, and then Mahaprabhu in Gambir, and the last is Mahaprabhu dancing in front of Lord Jagannath. And in front there's big, beautiful Panchatattva calling and inviting everyone to come be seated inside the innermost chambers of Srila Gurudev's heart. So, yeah, I remember, I can't believe how much has been done in just 1 year. Last year we were all walking around with Shivad Premananda Prabhu, and he was saying, there's going to be the gopis, there's going to be Sevakulis, this is going to be Govardhan, and it was just completely like cement and bamboo everywhere, and we're just thinking like where and how and, you know, who's going to do this, and, but Srila Gurudev has mercifully manifested everything, and in such a quick, so quickly too. So, you know, we have about another year left of work to do for the Samadhi, and now that a lot of the construction has been done, we need to make work on making it as beautiful as possible. So hopefully being able to paint the ceiling, do beautiful art on the ceiling, and also buying like different kinds of flooring for different scenes of the kunjas. Like for example, for Manani Rat, she's going to be sitting on a waterfall. So where's that waterfall going to come from? We have to create like rocks, we have to create water, we have to create, we have to buy artificial grass. We want each scene to be as close as possible to the picture, to the painting that Shamrani Devi did. And so by the mercy of the Vaishnavs, hopefully if everyone can just pull through and help in any way that they can, then you know we can complete this service for Srila Gurudev and Jai Guru. So some devotees have been asking why red tiles were chosen for the Samadhi. So there's a few things that come to my mind. The first is of course that nothing can happen without the blessing of Gurudev, because everything is happening under his direction. But also, the first thing that comes to my mind is that Gurudev was completely out of the box. I mean, we don't find anybody with a red samadhi, but Gurudev, there isn't anybody like Gurudev. I mean, Gurudev was just so bold and just didn't fit into any tradition or any box or anything like that. He was like extremely revolutionary, extremely one of a kind, and extremely like bold, like the color red. And also, when it was Gaur Purnima time, actually Padmanabh Maharaj told me a story. It's written in Prabh Gurudev's biography. Prabh Gurudev establishes these three steps leading up to the altar in Devananda Gaudiyaman. So Gurudev was asking like, what is the meaning of these steps? I think one is yellow, one is black, and one is red. So he was like, oh, this one is for Radharani, this one is for Krishna. And then Gurudev says, okay, but what about the red one? So Param Gurudev's like, gets kind of emotional, and he says, oh, this one is for a very special Sakhi. So, can leave you wondering who that very special Sakhi is, but Samadhi is beautiful and bold and red, just like Srila Gurudev and like Srila Gurudev's heart. Jai Gurudev. Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev, Shu Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev. Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev.
On the top of Samadhi Mandir, we are making five domes. Four domes are at four sides and one at the center. The domes will be placed on pillars of height minimum 3.5 feet, and on that the dome will be made. It will be same like the domes which are beside and on Keshavji Mutt, Navadeep.
Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev, Swagatam Gurudev, Suswagatam, Suswagatam, Suswagatam Gurudev, Suswagatam, Suswagatam, Suswagatam Gurudev.
My name is Hare Krishna Das, and I'm here to share with you just wonderful experience that I'm feeling now that Gurudev Samadhi has is just rapidly manifesting. You know, just under a year before there was nothing there, and now Gurudev has this wonderful place. You know, I specifically got the chance to come there and see how beautiful everything is manifesting. All Gurudev's pastimes are there. Seva Kunj and all the Goswamis are there, and all our great parampara is there with Gurudev. And personally, I've been doing a seva of you know, helping some devotees who want to give donations to the Samadhi. And actually, Samadhi is a really important place for us. Actually, It says from the Vaishnavas that Gurudev Samadhi is like a deity, and it's a connection to the spiritual world. It's even higher than Vrindavan or Navadip. It's all the holy dhams are present there in the Samadhi. So this is not an ordinary place. And for us to have this great opportunity to serve our Gurudev and be part of this is actually something very merciful from him, that he has given us this chance. And I'm so humbled by the service that all my God brothers and God sisters are doing. I've seen how hard they work, you know. They even, you know, laid out the bricks, you know, building up the walls, and without distinctions, you know, people from all countries are coming here to serve Srila Gurudev, and it's really heart-touching. And there's many ways that, you know, we can be part of this. You know, you can come here and help all these Vaishnavas that are doing so much seva, decorating, painting, and there's so much service to do still. You know, we're just building. It's just been a year, but you know, anything that, if you feel some inspiration to serve Srila Gurudev, this is your great chance. Srila Gurudev is still present with us, and he's specially giving all his mercy there in this place where his deity is present. So anything that you do from your heart, you know, so, you know, if you have a chance, then please try to be part of this wonderful project and get the blessing of Srila Gurudev. Hare Krishna.
Srila Gurudev ki jai. So when I think of the Samadhi, I picture it as like a lotus flower, like a multi-dimensional lotus flower, where Gurudev is at the center, and like around him he's manifesting like all these kunjas, like very fragrant, beautiful kunjas, and he's attracting everybody like throughout the world to say like, hey, I'm still here. And he's like, just like before, how Gurudev was sharing everybody with everybody his moods, now still he's manifesting these like externally in the form of his murtis and the Guru Parampara, and like he's saying like, I'm still here, please, I'm inviting you, come inside my heart, come smell the sweetness, come to Braj. And when I'm here in the Samadhi, I feel like it's alive, like especially now, like every day people are coming and looking at the murtis, and so many people are coming and doing seva like just naturally from their heart, and I'm so inspired because it's reminding me so much of festivals of Gurudev, and just reminding me how he's still present and he's still arranging everything. And yeah, it's just been very magical, and I'm very happy to be here.
My name is Anupam Das from Mexico. What had happened with Samadhi in 1 year? Everything has happened in Samadhi in 1 year. 1 year ago, we didn't have anything. Now we have a beautiful three-story building with all Radha Krishna Leelas manifesting there. Slowly, slowly, they're becoming real. We have the whole parampara except Gurudev. Gurudev still missing. We need help for that. Gurudev Murtis. The place is beautiful, in the middle of the second floor, but not murti yet, because we don't have enough artists. We need somebody to help us finish it. Gornitai, they have come too, but they're not painted. What else can we say? It's slowly, slowly is becoming alive, but we need a lot of help for this to happen. We are all Gurudev daughters and sons. It's our duty to make it happen, because this is the place where Gurudev is manifesting his godless mercy.
Hare Krishna, my name is Jayadev Das. We are right now in Vrindavan Dham. It's really important right now to understand, like, we are living in the moment when the Samadhi is in the progress of construction. It's since like Gurudev entering Nitya Lila. It's the first time they take, like, by mercy of the Vaishnavas, they start to do and manifest in the place. If you already be in India, you know how hard is even just stay here, and especially the people are there in the Samadhi working, they're doing and doing a really wonderful seva. It's amazing. we already have the opportunity. We are to take some darshan of the new murtis, the new place. But it's amazing how this samadhi is the biggest, is one of the biggest I saw in all India, in all Parampara, and it's kind of really like a high goal to finish this samadhi in the how Gurudev expect from us. It's so much we can provide. It's a unique opportunity in this life. We don't know if we're gonna get this opportunity again. Put a little of us, a little seva in the samadhi. So I hope someone feel touched, inspiration by this humble words, this humble request from Vrindavan Dham. So that's all. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. I just would like to express how grateful I am to be a part of this team here working on a samadhi. I came for Navadvipa Parikrama and I was really encouraged to stay and help Radhika with painting the murtis. And it's really sweet to be here and be a part of this. I met Gurudev in 2009 and unfortunately I didn't have so much time to do service for him directly while he was here. So I feel that this is an amazing opportunity to serve Gurudev and strengthen the bond that I have with him. Thank you.
Hello.